They did not have enough beds, or enough food, or even half enough money for a family of seven. All of the grandparents were over 90 and haven't left their bed in over 20 years. Mrs. Bucket was always there to help. Mr. Bucket was the only one with a job. He worked at a toothpaste factory, where he sat all day long at a bench and screwed the little tips onto the tops of tubes of toothpaste. And as for their daughter Charlie, well, she is pleased to meet you.
I'm pleased to meet you.
I wonder what's for dinner tonight.
If it's cabbage soup again, I'd rather drop dead.
Calm down, dear.
What's that?
I said calm down, dear.
Come over. No, I'm all ready. It's
all ready. Hello, Mom. Hi, Dad. Good to see you, Grandpa Joe. Grandma Josephine. Mm-hmm. Grandma Georgina. And Grandpa George.
And dinner?
Yes. What is for dinner tonight?
Cabbage soup again tonight.
Cabbage soup.
Cabbage soup.
Candy poop.
No, dear, not candy.
Someone say candy? I walked by the factory again today. Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. To and from school, every time I do. Imagine this, grandparents. Close your eyes. Every time I walk past the factory, I begin to walk very, very slowly, and I hold my nose high in the air and take long, deep sniffs of the gorgeously chocolatey smell around me. Smoke billowing from its chimneys, whizzing sounds coming from deep inside the factory, and the layers of chocolatey, caramelly, deliciously lovely smells. Oh, how I love that smell, and how I wish I could go inside the factory and see what it's like.
But you can't go inside the factory.
Well, I've done that.
What? You never told me about that.
Grandpa Joe used to work there long ago when the factory first opened.
Oh, Jolly, what a funny to hear about all that.
Tell me, Grandpa, I want to hear everything.
Oh, what a man, Willy Wonka.
Willy Wonka invented over 200 different kinds of candy bars. Each bar is sweeter and creamier and more delicious than any of the other chocolate factories can make.
Charlie, Willy Wonka can make rich caramels that change color every 10 seconds as you eat them, and marshmallows that are delightful, and little feathery sweets that melt away deliciously the moment you put them between your lips.
Until one day.
Yeah, somehow it all went terribly wrong. Disastrous. Despicable.
Cabbage soup!
What went wrong, Grandpa?
Well, not very long ago, there used to be thousands of people working in Mr. Wonka's factory. But then one day, all of a sudden, he had to ask every single one of them to leave, to go home, and to never come back.
But why?
Because of spies.
Spies?
Well, you see, Charlie, all the other chocolate makers had begun to grow jealous of the wonderful candies that Mr. Wonka was making. So they began to send spies to steal his secret recipes. Soon after that, Fickle Gruber's factory started making the same ice cream that would never melt. And Mr. Prodnose's factory, the same candy sticks that you would light on fire once you eat them. And so, that Mr. Slugsworth, well, he started making the same candy balloons that you could blow up to enormous sizes before you popped them and gobbled them up. All the same as Mr. Wonka.
So, everyone was ordered to leave and the factory was closed.
But one day, months and months later,
early in the morning, white smoke was seen coming out of the tall chimneys.
The factory was working! You could hear the machines, they were all whirling again. And you could smell the smell of melted chocolate in the air.
But the gate was still locked.
The gate was still locked. But most mysterious of all, Charlie, were the shadows in the windows of the factory.
Tiny shadows.
George, we don't know about that.
I saw them with my own two eyes. They were tiny shadows.
That's just how perspective works, George. They were far away.
But when we saw Charlie, it looked like tiny little shadows moving about in the windows of the factory.
Shadows of whom?
I think it's a crew of babies.
That's exactly what everyone else wanted to know, Charlie. There are people in there, but no one has gone in. No one ever comes out either. The gates are locked.
Why doesn't someone just ask Mr. Wonka?
No one has seen him.
He never comes out, Charlie. The only thing that comes out of that factory is the chocolate and the candy.
Most of the day was a quiet and boring routine around the bucket home. But when Charlie was home, the whole family would light up with smiles. And in the evenings, an evening like this one, the stories would begin. For perhaps half an hour every night, this home would become a happy place, and the whole family would forget that they were hungry and poor. This family did not have enough of anything, but they had each other, and for Charlie Bucket, that was enough. As the night went on and they all fell fast asleep, none of them, not even Charlie, could have ever imagined how sweet tomorrow would be.
I wonder what's for dinner tonight.
Don't even ask.
Well, I'd like a cabbage soup.
Are you okay,
dear? Finally gone loony from that toothpaste factory.
Stop. What is it?
You've got news.
Mr. Wonka.
Yes?
Mr. Wonka.
Go on.
Wonka factory to be opened at last to lucky few.
You mean people are actually going to be allowed inside of his factory? Read us what it said. Look.
Mr. Willy Wonka, the candy making genius whom nobody has seen for the last 10 years, sent out the following notice. I, Willy Wonka, have decided
to allow 5 children, just 5, mind you, and no more, to visit my factory this year. These lucky 5 will be led around personally by me, and they will be allowed to see all the magic and secrets of my factory. Then, at the end of the tour, and as a special present, every one of them will be given enough candies and chocolates to last them a lifetime. So, watch out for the golden tickets. 5 golden tickets have been hidden under the ordinary wrapping paper of 5 ordinary candy bars. These 5 candy bars may be anywhere, in any shop, in any town, in any street, in any country in the world, upon any counter where Wonka's candies are sold. And the 5 lucky finders of these 5 golden tickets are the only ones who will be allowed to see my factory inside. So, good luck to you all, and happy hunting.
Signed, Willy Wonka.
The man's mad.
The man's Dottie.
Pardon me, no, I already went.
He's brilliant, he's a genius. Just imagine what will happen now. The whole world will be searching for those golden tickets. Everyone will be buying Wonka bars in hopes of finding one. Or to sell more than ever before. Oh, how exciting it would be to find one.
Wouldn't it be something, Charlie, to open a bar of chocolate and see a golden ticket glistening inside?
It certainly would. But there isn't a hope. I only get 1 bar a year.
You never know, Charlie. It's your birthday next week.
You've as much of a chance as anyone else.
I'm afraid it simply isn't true. All the kids who are going to find the golden tickets are the ones who can afford to buy candy bars every single day. Our sweet Charlie only gets 1 once a year. There isn't a hope.
Hello, I'm Rhonda Dolly, and reporting live from wherever my boss sends me to tell the news regarding the Wonka Willy Wonka's chocolate bar hunting hysteria. Just days in the competition, and the first golden ticket has been found. Young Augusta Gloop.
I just knew Augusta would find a golden ticket. She eats so many candy bars a day, it was almost impossible for her not to find one. Eating is a hobby, you know.
I love chocolate. I want everything chocolate. Milk chocolate, sweet chocolate, caramel-filled chocolate. Chocolate. I like chocolate more than any other food. I love it. Do you understand? I love it. And chocolate is my most reliable friend. I would train my own mother for chocolate.
Yeah, chocolate could be my mother. What a sweet girl! So silly and sweet. She's joking.
No, I would do it.
But there are worse things to love, right? And what I say is she wouldn't go on eating the way she does unless she needed nourishment, would she? It's all vitamins anyways. I think.
And what a great girl it is to visit Mr. Wonka's factory. I want to gobble up every room and make it all that chocolate and candy in the end. Chocolate. I love chocolate, did I say that? I love chocolate more than my own family. Much more.
We are just as proud as can be.
Well, that's that, I guess.
You know, there's two things I can't stand. People who are intolerant of other people's cultures, and foreigners. Kids greedy, I tell you. Greedy.
Needy? Joseph, do you think I am needy? Oh, stop. Charlie, hold your head up and smile. You've everything you need, you sweet girl.
Now things are really gonna get crazy.
I'm Rhonda Dolly, and reporting live, after 16 hours of travel, three layovers, and sharing a row on a plane with a sweaty, sad man named Melvin. And to all the Melvins out there, you deserve better, and at least you got to keep the cat. Big news today, the second golden ticket has been found. The lucky person? Young Veruca Salt, who lives with her rich parents in a great city far away.
You see, as soon as my little girl told me she simply had to have one of those golden tickets, I went out into the town and started buying up all the Wonka candy bars we could get our hands on. Hundreds of them I must have bought, hundreds of thousands. I'm in the peanut business, you see, and I've got about 100 women working for me. So I say to them, ladies, for now you can stop shelling the shells off these peanuts and start shelling the wrappers off these crazy candy bars instead. And they did. But 3 days went by and we had no luck. It was terrible. I got more and more upset each day. And every time my mom came home, I would scream at her, "Where's my golden ticket? I want my golden ticket!" And then I would lie for hours on the floor, kicking and screaming in the most disturbing way. I just hated seeing my little girl feeling unhappy like that. But then suddenly, on the fourth day, they got it! A golden ticket! I said, "Give it to me quick," and they did. I'm all smiles now. And we have a happy home once again.
That's even worse than the strange foreign girl.
They spoil it. And no good can ever come from spoiling a child like that, Charlie.
Happy birthday, Molly!
Charlie.
Charlie birthday, Molly!
We're all supposed to say it together, but
happy birthday!
Thanks, everyone. I knew you wouldn't forget.
We love you, sweet Charlie. And as tradition goes, one Wonka bar.
Wonka's Whipple Scrumptious. Much better. You'll just love it.
Yes, I know.
Now, you mustn't be too disappointed, my darling, if you don't find what you're looking for underneath that wrapper. Whatever happens, you'll still have that one bar of candy.
open it, open it.
Well, that's that, I guess. Here, Mother, have a bit. I want everyone to taste it.
But certainly not.
Now, Charlie, it's yours.
We wouldn't dream of it.
Please, we're in this together. Share the sweetness, you know?
Well, 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 the third golden ticket has been found. Little Miss Violet Beauregard. I remember Miss Violet from a few years ago when I covered a story on the National Gum Chewing Championship. Yep, there's a competition for everything these days. And so, Violet, tell us about yourself.
I'm a gum chewer, normally. But when I heard about these tick things from Mr. Wonka's, I laid off the gum and I switched to candy bars in hopes of striking it lucky. Now you see, I am right back on gum. I just adore gum. I can't really do without it. I munch on it all day long, except for a few minutes at meal times when I take it out and I'll stick it behind my ear for safekeeping.
Now, Mom Violet is a winner, but I still tell her that it's not ladylike to see a girl's jaw going up and down like hers does.
I don't agree. And who's she to criticize anyways? If you ask me, I'd say that her jaws are going up and down just as much as mine are from yelling at me every minute of the day.
Now, Violet,
get your hair on!
Well, if it interests you to know, this piece of gum she's chewing right at this moment is one she's been working on for over 3 months solid.
That's a record.
It's a record.
Well, that was unpleasant.
Despicable.
What a beastly girl.
There are still 2 more tickets left out there.
Don't give up yet, Charlie.
Let's see if there's anything else.
And so, in an unexplainably quick amount of time to get from one location in the world to another, we are now in a new home with the next winner of what turns out to be the 4th golden ticket. The winner of this 4th of 5 golden tickets, Michael TV.
My friends call me Mikey.
Oh, sorry, Mikey TV.
I said my friends.
I don't understand. When I was a kid, we went outside, we played in the dirt, Mikey, Michael, he just sits here hours after hours playing his games.
Oh, games are for kids. This is a realistic pirate puzzle-solving adventure, where I sneak into Captain Buckeye's cave, expertly take down swashbucklers and pirates, get past all the booby traps like the spike pit and the poison darts, then I solve the 1,000-year-old puzzle, which most people can't do. Then grab the ruby-dice skull, do it all in reverse.
I don't jump, roll! I don't know what that means.
I don't know why you're in my room.
Tell us about getting the golden ticket.
Can't you bobblehead see I'm in the middle of my game right now? I don't even like chocolate. I bet Billy Bonka has any cool games there.
We are really happy to get to go to the factory.
Me.
I think.
Riveting news.
How many more
of these do we have to do?
One more. Yeah, that's quite enough. You can turn it off.
One more. Only one. Joe, I just got home from school.
You wanted to have one last fling at finding that last golden ticket. All right, this is my secret hoard. The others don't know I've got it. Now, you take that money and you go round down to the nearest candy store and you buy a chocolate bar and gun straight back here, all right?
All right.
Go on now, Charlie. Come on. Go. Yes, Have you got it?
Are you ready?
Yes, yes, of course I'm ready.
Okay, you start.
Darn you, I'm too nervous.
Okay, together.
Together.
Well, that's the only chocolate.
What the heck's going on?
Nothing, nothing.
Sorry, Grandpa.
You go back to bed now. And you too.
So, the days are getting colder and colder as we wait for the final lucky golden ticket.
Wonka Boss sold here, get them while they last.
The stakes are high, but the hopes are low.
I've thought about hundreds of those things. Still, nothing.
The ticket could be anywhere but here, it seems. It seems that all that's left here are the poor, lowly children. No money, no food, cold streets, cold dreams.
Hey!
What? Just painting the picture, darling.
Hey there, what can I get you?
I'll take, this one.
Easy there. You can get yourself a guy. You've got a little sense left over. Anything else?
That one.
Enjoy. It's a golden ticket at my shop.
Hey, that's supposed to be mine.
What's for it?
I'll give you 500.
Breaking news, the fifth golden ticket has been found by...
Charlie Bucket.
Now, Charlie, tell me.
Get straight home.
I'll give you 1,000.
Stop. Go.
Get back here.
Let me see. Read just what it says, quickly.
Let's say, okay. Greetings to you, you lucky finder of this golden ticket from Mr. Willy Wonka.
I shake you warmly by the hand. Many tremendous things are in store for you, and wonderful surprises await you as I invite you to visit my factory for one whole day.
I, Willy Wonka, will conduct you around the factory myself, showing you everything that there is to see. And afterwards, you'll be escorted home by a large truck full of years' worth of candy and delights.
But this is by no means the most exciting thing that will happen on the day of your visit. I'm preparing other surprises that will entrance, delight, intrigue, astonish, and perplex you beyond measure.
In your wildest dreams, you could have never imagined that such things could ever happen to you. Just wait and see. And now come to my factory on the 1st of February at 10 o'clock sharp in the morning? No!
You're allowed to bring one member of your family to look after you and to ensure that you don't get into mischief. See you soon. Signed, Willy Wonka.
The 1st day of February. That's tomorrow.
Charlie, how exciting!
But who will go with Charlie?
I will. I'll take him. Give him to me. Okay. Let's get going. Hold on. I gotta take my pants off first. All right.
Eyes on the prize.
So
Why are we talking? This exciting job.
Oh, there he is.
Can you come forward one at a time, please? Show me your ticket and give me your name. Who's first?
I'm Augusta Gloop.
Augusta Gloop, my dear child. So delighted to meet you. Charmed, overjoyed to have you with us. Come, come, step through the gates.
Can I hug you?
Absolutely not.
Oh. I'm Veruca Salt.
My dear Veruca, how do you do? You do have an interesting sort of name, don't you? I always thought that a Veruca was a sort of war that you got on the bottom of your foot, but I must be wrong.
I'm Violet. Do I win?
How exciting, once again, charmed. Welcome.
So sorry, Mr. Wonka.
And you?
I'm Charlie Bucket. I'm pleased to meet you.
So sweet to meet you. Delighted, enchanted, enraptured. Is that everyone in now? Five children, five tickets. Good, here we go. See you soon. Good, follow me down this hallway. Okay, turn left.
Where are we? I can't see a thing.
Left, then right, left. Okay, very good, everyone. Right, right, left, no, right, very good. Augusta, don't touch that. We have arrived. Welcome. Welcome, one and all, to the chocolate room. This is a very important room. This is the nerve center of the whole factory, the heart of the whole operation, and so beautiful. Look there, it's chocolate, it's all chocolate. Every single drop of that river is hot melted chocolate of the finest quality. And just look at the pipes. They suck up the chocolate and carry it away to all the other rooms in the factory. Now the waterfall, over there if you would, is most important. It mixes the chocolate, it churns it up, it makes it light and frothy. I'll have you know that no other factory in the world mixes its chocolate by waterfall. So look around, taste around. Because, of course, almost everything in this room is eatable. Take a bite. Bon appetit.
Veruca, right here.
Oh, Violet, try that.
Slow down, Augusta.
Don't ruin my footage. Isn't this incredible, Charlie?
Grandpa, have some of these.
Ooh.
Aren't they wonderful? The taste is like nothing I've ever tasted before.
Wait, what is that? Morlach, who is that?
Oh, that is an Oompa Loompa. There are more too. Hey there, you're doing great work.
He's alive? Like, those are real people.
Well, of course he is. He's one of the many Oompa Loompas that live and work here with me in the factory. Aren't they terrific?
Is he edible?
Oh, no, not at all.
Where did he come from?
Direct from Oompaland, of course.
How did he get so tiny?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll delete that.
It's okay. That's just how perspective works.
Did you say Loompaland? There's no such place as Loompaland.
Well, of course there is.
Mr. Wonka, I'm a teacher of geography.
And then you'll know all about it and what a terrible country it is. Nothing but thick jungles infested by the most dangerous beasts and desolate wastes. Hornswogglers and snozzwangers and those terrible wicked wangdoodles.
That's weird.
That's amazing.
A snozzwanger would gobble up 10 Oompa Loompas in the morning and think nothing of it. So, when I went out looking for new and unique cacao beans, I found the Oompa Loompas and I said to them, come and work with me in my factory in safety and comfort. And of course, chocolate. And out of the grasp of those terrible vermicious canids and the,
Gognacks.
The gruesome Gognacks. And so they're here.
Mommy, I want an Oompa Loompa. I want you to get me an Oompa Loompa. I want to own that man right there!
Maybe later, sweetheart.
But I want one!
Okay, okay. Make sure you have one before the day's over.
Augusta! Augusta, sweetheart, I think you'd better do that.
Oh no, Augusta, please, I beg of you not to do that. My chocolate must be untouched by human hands.
Delicious.
Augusta, come away now.
You're leading to Haru.
Coated glue, no one would buy it.
Then what exactly are we supposed to do?
Oh, she's...
Oompa!
Any minute now, Mrs. Gloop. All right, I'd like you to take Mrs. Gloop up to the fudge mixing room to find her child. She's kind of up the pipe. Okay, now listen, pull yourselves together. Oh, no, of course not. That would be terribly rude. Now, I want you to go to the chocolate mixing room, and once you get there, take a large stick and start poking around in the large chocolate mixing barrel. I'm almost certain you'll find her there. All right, Mrs. Gloop. Just that way. All of that. Now, a special gift should be awaiting us very soon. Mikey, was that you? Put it down.
A boat? What kind of factory has a boat?
Any good factory.
My factory doesn't have a boat.
I said any good factory. Now, enter carefully, one at a time. There are accommodations in the boat, drinks. And I would like every single one of you to get to know each other for a moment.
Old ladies first.
Is that a screw?
I'm used to bigger boats.
You can go first, Grandpa.
It's a delightful boat.
I swear if my suit rips.
I really like it.
Yeah, it looks really rickety.
Can this support all of us?
Maybe. This tunnel system leads throughout the entire factory. No better way to get around than by boat, they say. Of course not.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Well, I'm the more wooden swimmer, so if you fall out, I could save you.
You would save me?
I said I could.
Does this thing go any faster?
This is quite the ride, Grandpa.
Hang on tight, Charlie. Enjoy it.
Is the river getting narrower?
I think the tunnel's getting darker.
What is that coming up?
Full speed ahead!
There's no knowing where they're going! There's no earthly way of knowing which direction we are going. There's no knowing where we're rowing or which way the river's flowing. Not a speck of light is showing, so the danger must be growing.
He's insane!
No, he's not. Will the rowers keep on rowing? And they're certainly not showing any signs that we are slowing.
Look, Grandpa, there's more in the wall. Vanilla cream and hair cream.
Four, there's no time to answer silly questions.
Whips? What on earth do you use whips for?
For whipping cream, of course. How can you get whipping cream without whips? Forward!
Cacao beans, coffee beans, jelly beans, and happy. You win yourself, and there's no time for arguing. Faster, faster, wait! Stop the vote! Just over there. You have arrived. And remember, get off in an orderly fashion.
Thank you, Charlie.
I think we're gonna be best friends.
I may be your best friend.
I've got sea legs.
Send her away. This is a very important room. All my secrets and new inventions are cooking and simmering in here. Welcome to the inventing room. Now listen, this room is much different than the last one. No touching, no meddling, and absolutely no tasting. Is that agreed?
Of course, fine.
No promises.
Mikey? Up to now, nobody else, not even an Oompa Loompa, has ever been allowed in here. Oh, good. They're ready. This is an everlasting gobstopper. They're completely new. You can take one of these, put them in your mouth, and suck on them, and no matter how long you try, they will never get any smaller.
It's like gum.
It is not like gum. Gum is for chewing, and if you try chewing on one of these, you'd break your teeth off. But the taste is terrific. They change color once a week, and they never get any smaller. Never,
never.
There's one of these being tested by an Oompa Loompa, and he's had it in his mouth for nearly a year now without stopping, and it's still as good as ever.
Amazing.
Now, over here, if you will, all this way, I'll show you something that I am terrifically proud of. Be careful, stand back, and watch. That's all? That's all? Don't you even know what that is?
Five gum, it's gum!
Right you are. It's the stick of my most fabulous, sensational, and amazing gum in the world.
How so?
This stick of gum, like right there, is my latest, my greatest, my most fascinating invention. It's a chewing gum meal. That little strip of gum hiding behind a glass panel is a full 3-course dinner all by itself.
About the things we could do with that gum?
Right you are, dear lady. It would be the end of all kitchens and all cooking. No washing up, no cooking, no garbage, no mess. Just this tiny little strip of Wonka's magic chewing gum. And that's all you'll ever need at breakfast, lunch, and of course, dinner.
What flavor is it?
Just a moment. This piece I've made happens to be tomato soup, chicken dinner, and blueberry pie. It's utterly delicious.
It's utterly impossible. Well, I don't know if y'all forgot, but I'm a gum chewer. So if it's gum, it's for me.
Now, Violet, don't do anything silly.
What is so silly? I want the gum.
Well, first of all, there's a reason it's behind a glass panel. And second of all, and to be honest to all of you, this is one of my more new inventions. There may be one or two things that...
Oh, who cares?
Violet, don't.
Fabulous! It's tomato soup! It's hot, and it's creamy. Oh, Mom, it's delicious!
Stop. It's not ready.
I can feel it running down my throat. And now, the main course, chicken!
Violet, do not listen to him. He's chewing.
Spit it out.
And now, blueberry pie and cream. Oh my, it's perfect. It's wonderful. It's like I'm eating big spoonfuls of the most marvelous blueberry pie in the world. Wonka, I need more gum. I need more of it. Mom, I need more gum.
Violet, what is happening to you?
What do you mean?
She's swelling up.
She's blowing up like a balloon.
Like a blueberry, Mrs. Salt. And...
Violet, you're turning violet, Violet.
Stand by, Charlie.
I told you I hadn't got it quite right yet. I've tried 20 times on 20 different Oompa Loompas, and they've all ended up as a blueberry. Can you imagine how annoying that is?
But I don't want a blueberry for a daughter.
Mom!
Oompa!
Roll Miss Beauregard into the boat and take her along to the juicing room at once. Is that understood?
Excuse me, the juicing room? What are they gonna do to her?
Squeeze her, of course.
Oh no!
Don't worry now. I'm sure she'll be as good as new in no time.
Grandpa, listen.
I think they're starting to sing.
Dearest friends, we must agree, there's almost nothing worse to see than some repulsive little bum who's always chewing chewing gum. Sneaky habits down the scent, the chewer to a sticky end. But we'll try so hard to save Miss Violet Beauregard. Suffering an evil fate, there's still time, we're not too late.
Big, on this so disgusting, why do you make it in your factory?
Oh, I do wish you wouldn't mumble. I can't hear a word you're saying. Now, off we go.
What's next, Mr. Wonka?
Well, two naughty children gone, three children left. I think we'd better look at one more thing in this room before we leave. Now let's go!
Can you call me slow?
Impossible, and we've arrived.
Where is that exactly?
Here, of course. We have arrived.
The nut room?
Well, feel free to take a peek through the glass panel of this door, but don't go in. Whatever any of you do, do not go in. If you go in, you'll disturb the squirrels.
Look, Grandpa, look!
Baruka sing!
Squirrels!
Whoa! It's an amazing sight.
There must be 100 squirrels.
These squirrels are specifically trained at getting the nuts out of walnuts. Nobody except squirrels can get the walnut nut out of a walnut shell every single solitary time. Aren't they wonderful?
Incredible.
And see how they first tap each walnut with their little knuckle to be sure it isn't a bad one. And if it is a bad one, they just throw it down the garbage chute. Right there in the middle of the room.
Oh, look, that one just got a bad one.
And you just threw it away.
Mommy, I've decided. I don't want an Oompa Loompa. I want a squirrel. Get me one of those squirrels.
No, my dear. These belong to Mr. Wonka.
But Mommy, you know I don't care about that. I want one. All I've got at home is 2 dogs and 4 cats and 6 bunny rabbits and 2 parakeets and 3 canaries and a green parrot and a turtle. But Mommy, you know the turtle doesn't count because he barely even does anything. And a bowl of goldfish and a cage of white mice and a stupid old hamster. But Mommy, I want to score.
Mr. Wonka.
Oh, she can't have one. They're not for sale.
Who says I can't?
I do.
I'm going to grab one this instant.
Now, Veruca, don't. Probably should have done something more, and that probably should have been locked.
It's locked.
How mysterious.
All the squirrels have stopped what they're doing.
They're staring at her.
Why aren't you trying to get us in there? Veruca, what are they doing?
Uh-oh.
They're going after her.
Oompa! Can I have a key to the nut room, please? When you get the chance, and how are things going, by the way? Yes, the key, now.
Oh, she's trying to fight it. The squirrels are winning!
Mommy, what? Mommy, save me!
I can't look.
I can't.
Great, thanks.
I'll take that. Wonka! Veruca! Sweetie! Where are you? They're down the chute.
What?
That particular garbage chute leads straight to the furnace room.
The furnace? Like to burn the garbage?
I assure you there's a chance that they've decided not to light it Today, of all days.
A chance?
Oh, they're definitely fine. Probably. Oh, how lovely!
Veruca saw the little group just went down the garbage chute. She will meet as she descends a rather different set of friends. Lots of trash, other things as well, each with a rather horrid smell. Who spoiled her? Who did that? Who turned her into such a brat? It was her mom. We're glad she fell down the garbage chute as well.
Great song. So spontaneous, shall we move on? Right this way. Gather around, everyone. We're gonna have to make another trip.
What's this, Mr. Wonka?
It's obviously an elevator.
This isn't just an ordinary up and down elevator. This elevator can go sideways and long ways and slant ways, any ways you can think of.
Too bad there's something cool to see.
Choose a button, they're all labeled.
Right.
Candy mine.
10,000 feet deep.
Invisible candy bars for eating in class?
Stick job for talking.
Exploding candies for your enemies!
Come on, we don't have all day. How about that one?
Television chocolate.
That's for me. Yeah!
Okay, everyone, hands together, please. We don't need anyone falling off.
Oh. How is this thing moving?
I'm not quite sure myself.
It's like being on a roller coaster. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Oh, please don't be sick.
I can stop.
Can't do that. Not till we get there. I only hope no one else is using the other elevator.
What other elevator?
Oh, the same elevator that goes on the opposite track as this one.
I think I am gonna be sick.
Oh, don't do that, we're nearly there. Oh. Well done, everyone and everyone. We are done. Step off one at a time, please.
What the heck is all this?
Watch. This is my latest, my greatest, my most fantastical invention, television chocolate.
What's that?
Look, we take an oversized candy bar and place it here. And it has to be oversized because, just like filming on an ordinary television, it will always end up smaller on the screen. And before we do this, goggles!
Goggles? Why do we need goggles?
Thank you.
You'll see. Thank you.
They even fit over glasses.
All right. Then, just like an ordinary television, we take a picture. Lights, camera, action! The chocolate bar is broken into tiny, of nearly a million little pieces and is sent whizzing across the air to be put back together again on the screen and only smile.
That's literally not how TV works.
I'm a little deaf in my one ear. I can't hear a word you're saying, but I implore you to watch as it appears on that screen over there. Go on, get it.
How can I? It's on a screen.
Okay then, you get it, Charlie. Let's go. Taste it.
It's delicious.
Imagine thousands of people across the country watching their screens, sitting around when a commercial comes on saying, "Eat Wonka's chocolates. They're the best in the world. Don't believe us? Try one for yourself." And they simply reach out and take it.
That's terrific.
That's incredible. You could send anything, couldn't you?
Well, of course I could.
What about people?
Why would I want to send people? That's called cannibalism and is frowned upon in many cultures, Mikey.
You created teleportation. I mean, you could send a person, right?
Oh, sure I could. Of course I could. Maybe. There might be some nasty results.
Well, I'm gonna be the first person sent by television.
Mikey, wait!
I would not do that.
I would.
Lights! Camera! Action!
Where'd he go?
I'll tell you where he went. He's whizzing through the air in a million pieces.
Hopefully he'll pop up over there on the TV.
Well, let's see. Grab him, quick!
He's teeny tiny.
Oh, good, unharmed.
Unharmed?
Hey, man, look at me! First person sent by television!
He's so small! What can I do with this?
Oompa! Just a moment now, Mrs. TV. I'd say it's a bit tricky, but children are extremely springy and stretchy. Take him. The taffy puller room. Pop him in there for maybe an hour or so and we'll just see what we can do.
How far is he gonna stretch?
Maybe a mile. So sorry, right this way. I think we should get going. Never gonna finish this tour. And who's left now?
Oh, Mr. Wonka, there's only Charlie left now.
Only Charlie left, that means you're the only one.
Why, yes.
I'm delighted, I'm overjoyed. That means you won, you passed the test. I had a hunch from the beginning, you know, that it would be you.
But Mr. Wonka, what about the other children?
Oh, yes, the other children. Well, they got exactly what they wanted, didn't they? More candy, more gum, more things, more time on the screen. More. And we simply let them have it, but not you, Charlie. You have nothing. And yet you want nothing more than you have, and you are still here.
Mr. Wonka, I don't understand.
In due time, you will. But we mustn't dilly, we mustn't dally, we must be going. The fun is about to start. Step in. Be careful. Feel the need to kneel down. Now, press that.
Up and out.
Well, okay. Up and out.
Oh, okay. Oh. Whoa. Faster. If we don't go any faster, we are not going to get through.
Through what?
The glass ceiling, of course. I've been waiting to press this button for years.
Up and out!
Yippee!
Isn't this terrific?
Oh. This is my time!
I know. Is everyone still on?
Yes.
I knew that. I know. It's safe to stand up now.
Okay.
Where are we?
Let's go see your family, Charlie.
What?
Molly! Well,
I have someone I'd like you all to meet.
Well,
I still can't believe you're actually out here. I mean, outside the factory. I haven't seen you out here since...
You worked for me all those years ago. That's what it was. Oh, my gosh.
You remember him?
Well, at first, no. But when I saw our sweet little Charlie here, it reminded me of someone else. Someone who's grown into a kind and delightful old man. No less charming.
But I don't understand. What brings you here?
Charlie? What did you think of my factory today? Did you enjoy it?
Did I enjoy it? Mr. Wonka, I loved it. Today was the most magical, amazing day of my whole life. The chocolate factory is absolutely, without a doubt, the most wonderful place in the whole world, truly.
I believe you, Charlie. You see, I'd like to give it to you.
What?
You must be joking.
I'm deadly serious, Charlie. Listen, I want you to come and run the factory with me. When I'm older, someone will have to keep the factory going, look after the Oompa Loompas, and I know that there are thousands of clever adults out there who would give anything to have a job like mine, but I've decided that I don't want an adult. An adult won't listen, a grown-up won't learn, so I choose you, a child with imagination and joy in their heart, love, and a love, of course, of chocolate, someone I can tell all my chocolate-making secrets to.
So that's why you sent out the golden tickets.
Exactly, and you are the winner.
That all sounds so terrific, Mr. Wonka, but I can't leave my family here without me.
Well then, you don't need a family hanging around your head, so I'll be going.
Mr. Wonka, how can you do this? What happened to family and love and childlike wonder and imagination?
Please, Mr. Wonka, I just want to bring my family.
Reconsider.
Well, you get nothing. You lose. Good day, miss.
How could he?
At least I still have you guys.
You've done it, Charlie. You've truly done it. You've shown me that you can pass the test. You passed the test itself. I'm delighted. I'm charmed. I'm overjoyed. I'm enchanted. I'm so happy. I don't even know how to express my feelings. You've done it, Charlie.
Come on, I have an idea.
Breaking news, little lucky Charlie Bucket to join Wonka in his chocolate factory. Many more years of magical making must be to come. Hi, Charlie.
Willy Wonka? In my shop?
Is that Willy Wonka? Out here?
And Charlie Bucket.
No way! I figured with a lifetime supply of candy, I could spread some sweetness around here, you know?
Terrific idea.
Who wants some chocolate?
I do.
They're delightful, delectable, delicious.
I'm out of job.
Happiness.
In the end, the Bucket family gained a new home and a new life, full of more chocolate and tasty treats than they could ever imagine. Willy Wonka gained a partner in candy making. And as for Charlie, the girl who had nothing, but always had enough, she knew that with the people you love and some singing Oompa Loompas, life was only going to get sweeter.